Welcome back to System Dynamics. This is part 12, a continuation of the asset price drivers, looking at what can cause prices to rise and fall and speculating on the future impacts on economies and societies. Now we're looking at some dangers here of inflation taking root. Now initially people, you know, in their regular daily lives here, these individuals here, may not really notice inflation. They're buying things at the store and so on. And the official statistics produced by the government also, as we noted earlier, may be kind of understating that prices are rising. So over time, there may come a point where inflationary pressures become obvious and are really unavoidable. So in that case, a new phase of policymaking will start to emerge potentially, and that actually connects to the trends component here of our system here, trends and emotions as well, and our politicians who, of course, are going to be pressing for new laws to fix the problem. Here's the laws and legislation of the legal complex we've looked at before. The price controls are likely to be imposed in a highly inflationary environment. People obviously are going to be are going to be trading or buying things and see that the prices are kind of climbing and they're not liking that. So there's going to be a lot of heated discussion and pressure on politicians to do something about the problem. So we get to that price control legislation, let's call it, and that's going to be affecting actually the businesses right here. The businesses now will no longer be able to charge the prices that they had before by law, and it does impact on their cash flow, and that of course makes it harder for them to pay back their debt because they don't have as much cash flow to do so, as well as dividends. So both there can be problems for their debt as well, bad debt issues possibly, as well as their stocks and the stock market. So that is definitely a concern. On the other hand, the emotions are going to be strong. So you're going to have, while this has happened, of course, a lot of voters are going to be very supportive of these types of policies, and they're going to be putting pressure, of course, on the politicians to continue to try to get the businesses to behave themselves, because they're going to, of course, see the problem as originating from businesses and being greedy and so on, but not actually seeing that we're talking about actually a debt currency problem, where it's a proliferation of the debt currency that's now has gone through these stimulus type of payments over time, building up and causing more cycling of money through the reserves and individuals back and forth, as we've seen before. So that is what's really causing the inflation, but it's not going to be obvious to most people. These price controls can be extremely disruptive to an economy and cause hardship to both individuals and businesses, including shortages of goods, rationing of those goods, and long lines for people waiting to buy things. Now, a second example is more aggressive policies, such as tax and regulatory changes. And some of them can even be retroactive. So these can cause a very unstable planning environment for both businesses and individuals who become increasingly uncertain of their future tax obligations and compliance requirements, whatever they might be. We saw much earlier this crucial point here at the very right-hand side, paraphrasing from Friedrich Hayek, next to the legal complex here. Predictability and clarity in policy is absolutely key as part of the rule of law, so that people can kind of plan ahead with some idea of what's going on. So economic activity can suffer tremendously as decisions are made to forego investments, stop making new purchases here, and trading, exchanging, no more business startups and things like that on this side here. So this is all. Summing up here, while the stimulus policy may be pursued in an attempt to cure recessions, the broad-based inflation that can result is potentially very damaging. One is that the issue of poverty, The rising prices mean that those on relatively fixed income, including wage earners, as people going to the store have to pay more for what they were purchasing previously, they are all impoverished. Producers also are impoverished in a sense that they have to start cutting back on their expenses. They try to lower the use of more costly inputs, and they also can suffer from some of these policies that we've talked about that reduce their cash flow. All of this has the effect of potentially contracting economic activity and income earning opportunities. Thanks very much for listening. This concludes this part 12 of the system dynamics.